Morning, another beautiful day in God's kingdom. You know, today we're going to look at Rahab's life and pick up one or two things as we've been doing. And I'm going to struggle to contain myself within the time frame that I've set for these talks. But anyway, let's go ahead and see the bit that we have before us today. So we have Rahab now speaking to the spies in the book of Joshua, and we're in Joshua chapter 2, reading from verse 12. And she says to the spies, "Now swear to me by the Lord that you will be kind to me and my family, since I have helped you. Give me some guarantee that when Jericho is conquered, you will let me live along with my father and mother, my brothers and sisters, and all their families." And the men agree with her, and they say to her, "We offer our own lives as a guarantee for your safety. If you don't betray us, we will keep our promise and be kind to you when the Lord gives us the land." You know, and the first thing that I notice here is the fact that Rahab says to them, "Now swear to me by the Lord." She doesn't say, "By the Lord, your God." She doesn't say, "The Lord God that you serve." She says, "By the Lord," as though this Lord has become her own Lord as well. You know, and that is quite interesting. She has completely aligned herself, you know, with the Israelites. But anyway, she goes on and then begin to ask for the life of those that are precious to her. She asks for her life. She says, "Guarantee me that you'll be kind to me and my family." But who is that family? She says her father, mother, her brothers, sisters, their families as well. So basically everyone that is precious to those that are precious to her. So she extends the net as wide as she can, offering the opportunity to as many people as possible. And in the same way, when we pray, you know, I see a lesson there that when we pray, we shouldn't pray just for ourselves. We shouldn't pray just for our immediate loved ones, you know, maybe your husband, your wife, your children, or whatever. Extend that net as much as possible, that God, let your mercy extend to me, to my family, to my loved ones, to those that are precious to them as well. She includes as many people as possible. So it wouldn't be a surprise that maybe at the end of the day, she might have had up to 100 people in her house waiting for this salvation, waiting for this deliverance. And that is a lesson for us, that we can do the same thing as well. And then another thing that I see very quickly there is the fact that, you know, she said to them, "Give me this, you know, give me your assurance, give me your guarantee." And they find it easy to grant her request. Why? Because she had laid her life down on the line first, before they, you know, before she even began to ask the question, because she had told the king, "These men are not here." And if the king had discovered her deception, it was very likely that she would have been killed because of her deception and her betrayal. So she had already laid her life down for them. So it became easy for them to grant her request, because she had done it already before, you know, she had done the same thing for them, even before she knew that they would agree to her request. You know, so even in that as well, I see another lesson, that even before we begin to ask, you know, we ourselves must have presented ourselves as a living sacrifice to the Lord before we begin to ask for those things that are, you know, that demand God's intervention or God's mercy, that we ourselves have laid ourselves down, you know, as that living sacrifice that God desires. I'm going to stop there for today. God bless you. Have a beautiful day.